Good morning. Today the topic is CSMA. CSMA is nothing but carrier sense multiple access technique. So here, why we are opting for CSMA technique, even before we have discussed the concept packet radio protocol, why there is a drawback in it and what is it and how it is overcome in CSMA technique will be discussed here. So before the packet radio protocol, it is a contention protocol. In that one, many users can access a single channel, but they won't check or won't sense whether the channel is available or not. So because of that process, you'll be getting collisions. But even partial collisions can be avoided using slotted Aloha, but the complete collisions cannot be overcome, and it will not sense whether the channel is idle or not. Here comes a problem. The drawback can be overcome by CSMA protocol. Here, CSMA protocol, in this one, see here, Aloha protocols, they won't listen to the channel before transmission. That is, they will do not exploit information about other users. That is, if the transmitter one is ready to transmit the information and the transmitter two is also ready to transmit the information, they will directly transmit the data, whatever it has, without sensing whether the channel is available or not. And also, there will be no coordination among other users. If the transmitter one is transmitting and the transmitter two has to wait until the completion of the first transmitter. In this case, the collisions will be occurring more and they would not exploit any information among the other users. So before transmitting the information, we have to check the channel that will cause more efficiencies. This can be overcome using CSMA protocol. CSMA protocol is nothing but carrier sense multiple access. In the name itself, it is saying that it will sense the carrier, that is, it will sense the channel before engaging in transmission. So it is based on the fact that each terminal on the network is able to monitor the status of the channel before transmitting. So it will sense the channel whether it is idle or not. If the no carrier is not detected, then the user is allowed to transmit a packet based on particular algorithm, which is common to all transmitters on the network. So it will sense the channel whether it is idle or not. If it is free, then it will transmit the information. If it is not free, then it has to wait until the channel becomes free. So in CSMA protocol, there are two types of important parameters. The first one is detection delay and the second one is propagation delay. So detection delay, what is detection delay? So the detection delay is nothing but it's a terminal or the time required for a terminal to sense whether the channel is idle or not. So it's a function of receiver hardware. So the receiver hardware, it will check. So whatever the transmitter it is using to transmit the information, the time required for the terminal to check or sense whether the channel is idle or not, that parameter you'll be calling it as detection delay. And the propagation delay. Propagation delay means how fast it takes for the packet to travel from the base station to mobile terminal. The measure you'll be calling it as propagation delay. So these are the two important parameters you have to consider for the CSMA protocol. So with a small detection time, the terminal detects a free channel, that is quite rapidly. Small propagation delay means the packet is transmitted through a channel in a small interval of time relative to packet duration. So whatever the packet it is delivering at the receiver, it means if there is a small delay, then the packet is transmitted in small time. But here, out of these two important parameters, propagation delay is important. Why? Because just after user begins sending a packet, just before the user, if he is ready to send a packet, the other user may also be ready at the same time and also sensing the channel at the same time. If the transmitted packet, here is an example. First user is ready to transmit the packet and second user is also ready to send the packet. Just before sending the transmitter one, the transmitter two, he will sense the channel and also trying to send the packet at the same time. Whoever senses the channel free first, the channel will be available to that particular transmitter and he can able to transmit the packet. If the transmitted packet has not reached the user who is poised to send, that is whoever the transmitter is ready to transmit the packet that has been not reached, then the later user will sense the idle channel. See here, the first user, he is ready to transmit the packet. who is ready to transmit the packet. The other user is also ready to transmit the packet, but the first here, first comes first serve. So first user will send that, first user is ready to transmit the packet. Second user, before transmitting the packet from the first transmitter, he will send the channel. Second transmitter will send the channel and will transmit the packet. So whoever sends the channel first, they can transmit the packet. Firstly, the propagation delay is less, then the packet will be transmitted fastly to the receiver. So if both sensors, sensing the channel here is important. Why? Because one transmitter one will sense the channel a little later. The transmitter two may sense the channel before. So whoever sends the channel and first, they will transmit the packet, and after that one, the second user, first user is also sends the channel, that is free. If two will transmit the packet simultaneously, then also there will be a chance of collision. So here is some equation regarding the this FP, and that is propagation delay and detection delay. So here you can say FP is a propagation time in seconds, and RB is a channel bit rate, and small m is the expected number of bits that is transmitted in data packet. So then the propagation delay can be related as, it can be expressed as TD equal to TP RB by M. So this is the small equation related to propagation delay. And there are many strategies for several variations of CSMA. Those are one persistent, non-persistent, p-persistent, CSMA or CD. These are the different variations for the CSMA strategy. Coming to the first one, that is one persistent CSMA. One persistent means one chance. That is positive acknowledgement, you can take it as. See here, the terminal listens to the channel and waits for transmission until it finds the channel ID. So whoever the transmitter, he wants to send the message, he will first sense the channel whether it is idle or not. If the channel is busy, then he has to wait until the channel becomes free. If the channel is free, then the user, the transmitter, it will transmit the message with the probability 1. Here the probability 1 is described means if the channel is free at the first time only, then he will transmit the message with the probability 1. With first chance only, he can able to transmit the data. Second chance means if the channel is not free, then he has to send the channel again if it is available free. So this is the condition for one persistent CSMA. The second one is non-persistent CSMA. Non-persistent CSMA means in this one, after receiving negative acknowledgement from the receiver, the transmitter has to retransmit the packet because he has received negative acknowledgement from the receiver. That means the negative acknowledgement indicates the packet has been affected by collision, or else the packet has been dropped because of the collision. So this is popular for the wireless LAN applications where the packet transmission interval is greater than propagation delay. Okay, so this is non-persistent CSMA. Next, p-persistent CSMA. Here p-persistent CSMA means here the transmitter has to transmit the packet within allotted time slots. So for the first time slot, the probability of sending the packet, it is determined as, taken as probability p. And for the next time slot, he has to transmit the packet with the probability 1 minus p, and so on. So with allotted time slot, for the one slot, that a packet has been transmitted with probability p. For the next time slot, the packet has been transmitted with probability 1 minus p. And for the again, it is transmitted for 1 minus 2p, and so on until the transmitters are available with their messages. So this is about p-persistent CSMA. And the last one, it is CSMA CD. So here CSMA CD is nothing but collision detection. CSMA, carrier sense multiple access with collision detection. That is how the collision will be detected, whether it is detected at the transmitter or the receiver side. You have to keep a question in your mind that the collision will be detected only at the receiver, because the transmitter, it will transmit the packet after sensing the channel, and if the packet has not been received at the receiver, then the receiver has to think that the packet has been collided. So the collision will be detected at the receiver point of view only. Then the receiver has to send a negative acknowledgement to the transmitter that the packet has not been received. So this can be handled using both transmitter receiver, which able to support listen while talk. So when you're talking, you have to listen simultaneously. You have to do these two operations, listen and talk. So for a single radio communication, this can be done by interrupting the transmissions in order to sense the channel. For duplex channel systems, you'll be using full duplex transceiver, that is transmitting and receiving at the same time. Not to make these two operations, you have to use full duplex transceiver. The last one, it is data sense multiple access. So data sense multiple access is it's a special one. It completely depends on a forward control channel for a demodulation process before broadcasting data back on reverse channel. That is, data sense multiple access means after receiving negative acknowledgement from the transmitter, it will be completely depending on forward channel. So forward channel, it is transmitting the data. Reverse channel, it is receiving negative acknowledgement. So reverse channel, whenever it is receiving negative acknowledgement, it is nothing but demodulation process. So each user, they will attempt to detect a busy idle message, which can be interrupted by forward control channel. When this busy idle message, it indicates that no users are transmitting on the reverse channel, the user is free to send a packet. That is, whenever a busy idle message, that is, when the channel is very busy, then the channel will be busy only in the forward process only, because every user will try to transmit the data using the forward channel. If the packet is successfully transmitted at the receiver, then no reverse channel or negative demodulation or something has to be, the channel should be free in order to deliver this negative acknowledgement. So if the most of the packets are delivered perfectly at the receiver, then the reverse channel will not be busy. So similarly here, see, when the busy idle message indicates no users are transmitting on the reverse channels. So that is, if the on the reverse channels, if there is no busy idle message, then the user is free to send a packet. This is about DSMA. So this presentation represents about CSMA protocol, that is carrier sense multiple access protocol. In packet radio protocol, the problem is the users will transmit the data without sensing the channel. Here in CS, because of this one, many collisions are occurring, and it also reduces the efficiencies. In order to avoid this particular problem, you are using CSMA. CSMA is nothing but it will sense the channel before transmitting. Because of this one, greater efficiency can be achieved. And there are two important parameters, propagation delay and detection delay. Detection delay means, detection delay is nothing but it will sense the channel whether it is idle or not. Propagation delay means how fast the packets can able to transmit the message. And the propagation delay, detection delay, these are the two important parameters, and some equation is given by the propagation delay. And there are several variants of CSMA. One persistent, that is positive acknowledgement. If the channel is free, then he can able to transmit the packet with one probability. Otherwise, he has to wait for some time, and then again he has to retransmit with next probability. Next, non-persistent. Non-persistent means negative acknowledgement received by the receiver in case if the channel is busy, or if the if the collision has been occurred. Again, he has to retransmit by the transmitter. Next, P-persistent. P-persistent means the user has to transmit the packet with time slots. For first time slot, the packet has been delivered with the probability P. For the next time slot, the packet has been delivered with the probability 1 minus P, and so on. Next, CSMA CD. CSMA CD means nothing but it's a collision detection. The collision detection will be detected at the receiver only, and transmission reception both has to be controlled. Use like example of listen while talk. This can be achieved for full duplex systems using full duplex transceiver. Next, data sense multiple access. Data sense multiple access is important, which will be depending completely on forward channel for demodulating on the reverse channel. If the forward channel, if it is free of collisions, then the reverse channel will be free. If the forward channel is busy with collisions, then reverse channel will be busy. So this is about CSMA protocol. Thank you.